What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So we're going to be taking a look at some new upcoming hardware for maximum settings Linux cloud gaming PCs. This is a sponsored video by them, and I really appreciate their continued support here for the past few years on the channel. We're going to take a look at some game performance in this video, of course, and we'll talk more about the service. And for those who aren't familiar with what maximum settings is, we'll do a quick overview on how that works as well. So let's get started there. You'll see they are a Linux-based cloud gaming PC, which uses Moonlight software to do the streaming, which works really well. They currently offer monthly and hourly rates for their different tiers of service, and I'm a big fan of monthly rates myself. And everything here is priced very fair with good storage and great hardware that's all about to get a bit better. So let's take a look at that, starting with this right here. And these are all subject to change, but you'll see the 7900X and the 7800X 3D setup here is going to be their new top tier. This is going to be a bare metal tier that we'll talk more about later as well. And it comes with a lot of storage and the ability to buy some more time. You'll see what the new tiers are going to look like here at $10, $15, $20, and $30 a month. And I think the 7900 build for that price, especially with the storage that's going to be available, and again, bare metal, which we'll talk about more later, it's going to be a great deal if they're able to come in around these prices. Now, I mentioned Moonlight, which is what's used to stream maximum settings. So those who aren't familiar, you can download this software on just about any device, including your TV, your phone, tablet, all that type of stuff. And it's a really quick and easy setup. I have videos on the channel already if you want to go see more setup videos and dig deeper into this service, but I'll give you a quick look here as well in this video. So you're going to get a login from them once you sign up. So you're going to go into the login page, and once you log into the service, you're going to be able to start your rig up. But to set up Moonlight, the first thing you'll want to do is start it up in console mode. So you're going to click start and you'll see console mode right there. You click that, it'll start to rig up in console mode. Once it's started, you open up Moonlight and then you enter your cloud PC's IP address. You'll get this little lock here. You click that and you get a pin. When you get that pin, you click console here on their site, click here in the box and enter that pin and accept. That's going to link Moonlight up to the cloud Linux gaming PC, and you're going to be good to go in gaming mode and get moving. So what we're going to do after that is you'll just be shutting down the rig, and then you're going to restart it up in gaming mode so that you can connect with Moonlight and get to your desktop. So that's what we're going to do here. Click start, click gaming mode. Once it's started up, you'll see Moonlight will change over from this little icon of disconnected to open there. Once that happens, I can click on that and we'll be able to get connected to our desktop. It's a really quick and easy setup. I blew through it here just because this isn't a setup video, but I wanted you to see how it works. And again, I have a lot more in-depth videos on the channel. But once you get to your desktop here, it's just like any other PC desktop experience. It feels great with the mouse. They've really got latency down here. Bit rate's nice. Everything looks clean. I'm running 1440p, 65 megabits per second here. And you have a lot of different options you can play with. A lot of things come pre-installed, like the control panel, Steam, Lutris, Heroic Games, and Firefox for your browser. Now, I use Steam and Lutris mainly, so Steam for where most of my games are, and Steam works really well on this Linux PC, but I also use Lutris to run like Blizzard, EA, Epic, and Ubisoft. There's others you can do as well, like GOG, so I'm able to jump in and play something like Diablo 4 and Blizzard there, or something I might need those launchers for. But for me, most of my games are in Steam, and it does offer the easiest experience here when you're on this Linux cloud gaming PC from maximum settings. But this all works really well. It's easy to manage your games. And what's great about all of their tiers, especially their higher end, is you get plenty of storage for all of your games. You get plenty of faster SSD storage off the bat with your OS, but you also get a lot of mechanical storage that's pretty fast as well to store a lot of these games. And most cloud PC services don't offer near the storage that you get with max settings. Now, something else great about this tier is it's going to be their first official tier for 4K gaming. So I did jump into a few games at 4K, but I'm a 1440p gamer, and that's what most of my benchmarks will be. But their 4K streaming was great here with Moonlight. I did 4K 120fps streaming with some 4K 60 gameplay, and it felt very smooth with very little latency. And jumping into something like Doom as well at 4K 60 left me some overhead because not capped, I was at like 73fps, sometimes higher. So I capped it at 60 and very smooth for 4K. So I can definitely see this being a great tier for them when it comes to 4K gaming for those that need it. Now, we were talking about that bare metal setup. Basically, getting rid of the VM and giving you more direct access to that hardware is going to get rid of VM problems like using the GPU properly, performance, games that won't work, and all that type of thing. And you can see here in Cyberpunk, top being the normal setup, which you'll see in my video here in my game test, and the bottom is the bare metal that's coming with this tier, and with possibly the other tiers in the future, which will be awesome. And that bare metal setup is going to offer such better performance, as you can see here. So I'm really excited, not just for the top tier, but for potentially all the tiers, to have this new bare metal setup to really use the resources properly and give us proper performance here in the cloud with Linux. With all that being said, guys, I got a few games here, quite a bit, for you to take a look at in a trailer so you can see an idea of performance. I didn't want to go too deep into each game. It'll take too long, but when this setup actually comes out, we're getting full bare metal, we're getting all the performance, I will dive into more games and we'll dive into the service deeper. But in the meantime, take a glimpse of some game performance here for this 7900 rig from Maximum Settings. All right, guys, I hope that gave you just a general idea of what to expect for some gaming performance there, 1440p and 4K. Now, when this actually launches, which I can't say any exact dates now, though it'll be soon, I'm expecting even better performance, of course, with the bare metal setup, things being fleshed out, and they're really working on this, and I've seen so many improvements on these systems, so can't wait to check it out when it actually is fully released. We'll dive into some more games deeper that way, and this is great for Steam Deck users that might want to stick with Linux, but get some powerful hardware in the cloud. You can use Moonlight on your Steam Deck, or if you have other less powerful hardware and you want to check this out, or maybe you've never even tried Linux and you think it might be fun to mess around with it in the cloud, you can do that at very little cost to you out of pocket. But anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I really appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.